Hello, dear friends, and welcome to herodoof.com. Today we will do the second part of our GPD WIN review. Before this device, we used to play games with this and Nintendo 3DS. We don't have the console in our hands right now, or PlayStation Portable or PS Vita. But this, my friends, is the future of mobile gaming, and I'll show you why. This is GPD WIN, the first in the world mobile laptop in your hands. It's literally as big as Nintendo 3DS XL. It is powered by Intel Z8700, yes, with GPU Intel 405, 4 gigs of RAM, 64 gigs of internal memory. It supports micro SD, and it has, let me show you, it has a USB 3.0. This is Samsung Fit, 128 gigabytes, very small, very cool. It got USB Type-C, mini HDMI, this is a headphone jack, two four shoulder buttons, a vent, and a fan for the most demanding games. The fan got three modes. It's off mode for light gaming and internet browsing or watching videos. The middle mode, which is the first speed of the fan, and the last mode is the maximum power of the fan for most demanding games like, for example, you can even play GTA 5 on this thing. Yes, with low specs, it's doable, guys. Imagine playing GTA 5 in your pocket. This thing can do that. And let me tell you, the battery life on this device is exceptional under heavy gaming. I'm talking about, let me see, for example, Dragon's Dogma. You can play Dragon's Dogma on this. This is a very, very new game. You can play it 800 by 600 resolution, of course. You have to sacrifice something with everything on low. You can play it for about 3 hours. And this is very, very demanding game. I will show the game later on this review. So, full keyboard, two analog sticks, PlayStation buttons with the Xbox letters for Xbox, you know, games. This is the switch for the controller. This is in the middle part. This is the mouse mode, and you can move the mouse with the right analog stick, and this is the left click and the right click. Let me show you how it works. It's like that. This is the Xbox mode, and this is the D-pad mode. Another mode for another type of controllers. Xbox button. If you play Steam games run very good on this device, but I don't like online gaming and I don't like Steam. So, what more can I tell you about this device? The screen is exceptional. Very, very, very bright and very beautiful colors. The resolution is 1270 by 720. Yes, standard non-full HD resolution. These are the games that I've installed. I'll show you some of the games. As you can see, the logo is a little bit crooked, but what can you do? It's a Chinese device, but very good Chinese device. So, one thing that you should know, if you buy this device, you should be very, extremely very careful where you buy it from, because there is an older batch, and the older batch, my friends, is a piece of crap. It got driver crashing issues. The first device that I've received got these issues, so I had to send it back and get the new batch. This is the new batch of the device, and it's working flawlessly. There's no drivers crashing and nothing of the sort. No overheating, no nothing. And if you get the device, be careful how you meddle with the BIOS. Because if you turn off, for example, the GPU from the BIOS, this thing won't boot. And you have to do a blind re-enabling of the GPU, which is very, very hard. It is doable, but it's very hard. And just leave it like that. For example, I didn't update the Windows. I didn't do anything to update the drivers or anything like that. All the games run on stock Windows with stock drivers. And another thing, you should be very, very careful when buying microSD cards for this device, because it needs a fast microSD card. And if you want to play games from the microSD card, you should download and install. There was a program called it's here on the screen. Let me just start it. This is the program. It's GPD WIN Keep Alive. It keeps the SD card alive because it turns off in maybe 10 or 15 or 20 seconds, and you have to re-enable. You know, it keeps riding every 5 seconds. Keep riding on the SD card. Never mind. So, what more can I tell you about this device? As I said, the battery life is exceptional. If you internet browse on this thing, you can get about 7 or, I don't know, 8 hours. If you play light games, you can get about 4, 6 hours. Under heavy load, it can do at least 3 hours. At least 3 hours. So, now my friends, I will show you some games. So, and one thing that I forgot is that this is, by the way, this is Castlevania Lords of Shadow 2. You cannot play this game on your iPhone, let me tell you, friends, or your PlayStation Vita, or your Nintendo 3DS. As you can see, the game runs flawlessly. Perfect frame rate, no lag, no nothing. Amazing, incredible graphics, incredible. So one thing that I forgot to tell you is, when you charge the device, there are two ways to charge it. The first way is when it's off, completely off. And the second way is to charge it while it's on. Don't close the lid and charge it while it's still working, because I don't think that's a good idea. Why? Because somehow it shuts off the Windows and goes into some sort of a weird mode that I don't know. So don't do it. Charge it when it's off or when it's on, with screen on. So this is Castlevania Lords of Shadow 2. As you can see, the graphics are incredible. And on this particular game, you can play for about 3.5 hours with full battery, and it will be just fine. My fan is all the way on, because this is a very demanding game, as you can see. Demanding for this device, of course. You can break. Okay, let's break this son of a bitch. You can switch weapons, yes, of course, the fire hands or whatever the hell it is. But the game is so fast, and believe me, playing on physical controls is amazing. Yes, iPhone got some good games, you know, like Aralon, Lord of Forge and Flame. It's a very good RPG, but nothing like this. So, up to the next game. And now, Ghostbusters, the video game. What an amazing game, what an amazing graphics, what amazing story. This is, by the way, Ghostbusters 3 for me and many people. Forget about this new movie, it's total crap. So this is the game. And when you play with a lot of lights and explosions, there's no frame drop, or at least not that noticeable. As you can see, the frame rate is great. By the way, if you lower the resolution on some demanding games, like Dragon's Dogma, for example, that wouldn't be that much noticeable, because the screen is 5.5 inch and the game will look just as good. Yes, I will show you Dragon's Dogma. This will be the next game that I will show, and you'll see, because it's on 800 by 600, the screen is a little bit smaller, but the game runs. And this is the most important thing. The game is from 2016. Dragon's Dogma. 25 gigabytes of game. Very big game. You can destroy a lot of things. There is some sort of a mission here that I have to do with Pete, but what the hell is the mission? I don't know. Maybe I should put on my glasses. Oh yeah. Looking for some ghosts. Where the hell are they? By the way, I'm looking for Slimer right now. He's missing again. You know, the story of this game is so entertaining, so emotional and so cool. It's written by Harold Ramis and Dan Aykroyd, by the way. The game is voiced with the voices of the actors from the original movies. And it's just fantastic. I cannot believe that I can play these games on this device that fits in your pocket. Unbelievable. Unbelievable, my friends. And now up to the next game. And this is Dragon's Dogma. As you can see, the frame rate is very exceptional. Everything is on low, of course. But still, the game looks amazing. And let me tell you, this is a very, very cool game. An epic game. I am in some town right now. I'm supposed to do something. I'm sorry, I'm not in a fighting scene. But believe me, when the fighting starts, there's no frame drops or anything like that. As you can see, the game runs flawlessly. And you can enjoy it anytime. I don't think that this is more than 30 frames per second. But even 20 frames are enough. Because most of the games on the iOS, for example, Xenoblade, which is the most beautiful game on the iOS, runs on 30 frames. So 30 frames is amazing. And let's not forget that this fits in your pocket. This is not a big laptop. So when you say, oh, the frames are lower than 20 on GTI 5 or anything like that, don't forget that this is a pocket computer, a pocket handheld. So for a device like that to run this game is absolutely amazing. Keep in mind. So guys, that's it for now. There will be more games that we will review on our channel. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you have any questions, we will gladly answer it in the comment section. Have a nice day.
Thank you.